My name is Chris Curtis. I'm a corporate chef for Fox Restaurant Concepts. And I'm going to show you how to make pizza dough step by step. So first thing we need to do is add our water. This water's at between 65 and 70 degrees Fahrenheit. So you'll need a few pieces of equipment to make pizza dough at home. One, a KitchenAid mixer would be very helpful, a digital thermometer, and also two, a digital scale. We'll add our yeast. And then we're gonna add our honey. Not all pizza dough recipes call for honey. Some pizza dough recipes will call for a sweetener. Just to kind of help activate the yeast, and then from there we'll add our flour. So we have our organic flour from Central Milling. It's a custom blend for our restaurant. We'll add our buckwheat flour. This is also something very specific to our dough, and this helps give the dough a nice beautiful color, but also to some great flavor as well. Now we'll start mixing the dough. Right before the dough goes into the container that we're going to proof the pizza dough in overnight, we're just going to brush it with a little bit of olive oil so that as the dough rises and starts to proof, it doesn't get stuck to the inside of the container. Now we've got our dough out, it's been in the refrigerator overnight, it's doubled in size, and we're ready to portion the dough. It's basically divided into the size pizza balls that we want to work with. So to do that, we're going to brush our countertop, it's nice and clean, a little bit of olive oil, and then we're going to turn the dough out onto the table. This is when our digital scale comes into hand. And we're going to portion the dough into about 7 ounce portions. And that seems to be a good size for home chefs. Have just a smaller piece of dough left over, that'll work out great for a kid's size pizza. So once we have our dough portioned to this base, we want to have a container to allow the dough to do a second rise. So I like to use a sheet pan. We'll brush it with a little bit of olive oil so it doesn't get stuck. Here we're going to take the dough and fold it under itself like this, creating a nice smooth surface. We'll put it back on the table with the loose end down. Take the dough and using our hands,
just going to spin it around in a circle like this, just applying gentle pressure down onto the dough. It's kind of like you're massaging the dough ball. Then you look on the bottom, you'll see how it's starting to twist up onto itself. And once you see that it's coming together, just pinch it closed with your fingers, creating a nice tight seam. And then it goes back on to the tray. Alright, then before these go back in the refrigerator to proof for another 3 to 4 hours would be ideal. Or you could leave them out at room temperature and allow them to proof out at room temperature for about an hour and a half if you're in a rush. Before we let them proof, we're just going to brush them with a little bit more olive oil. You can use grapeseed oil or canola oil, something a little bit more economical, but I like using olive oil. Alright, so our portions of pizza dough have been in the refrigerator for a few hours now. We're at room temperature. They've started to relax, which will really help us stretch them out in a more even way. We'll have to struggle trying to open up the dough if it's too cold or still too tight. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to use a wooden pizza peel. We're going to put some flour down on the peel. Just pick the dough up. Now the part of the dough that's down on the tray, we want to keep it on the bottom of the board, top of the board rather. And here, I'm just going to sprinkle some flour on the dough so it doesn't stick to our hands while we stretch it out. And then from here, we're just going to gently press down on the dough. We want to keep about a half inch perimeter around the sides. That'll be our crust. And we don't want to knock all the air out of the outside of the dough, and that'll end up resulting in a flat, kind of chewy, not nice and light and airy pizza dough. And then from here, we're going to pick up the dough, and just using our fingers, we're going to let the dough kind of stretch itself out. Gently going around, the gravity is going to pull the dough out for us. Now put it on the back of your hands and gently stretch it. With a little bit of practice, you'll be able to get this down pretty easily. And then from here, you're free to build your pizza. Hope you enjoyed making pizza dough with me today. For more information, check out Phoenix Magazine's July issue.
Hold on, one second.